Okay, back for part two, round two. Things are already getting set up. If you missed the end of part one, I was like debating whether I wanted to make this two parts or not, and then I decided, hey, let's make it two parts. So, nice sentry position there. Gets cover from everything. And if they really want to come down and contest you on the cart, like this secures the cart for a few feet, which is nice. Kumin getting a good angle for spam here, but he ditched his entire team to do that, which is really silly because he really needs to be the one up here right now. Like, look, you can try and kill it, but we're just gonna back out. We're gonna keep it up as long as possible. Okay, you just wasted an entire Uber to kill a sentry gun and only got it after the Uber. Now, granted, you have the flank area now, which is nice. This is a much faster cap time than what we saw before, though. They were really having trouble for a little bit getting this first point last time. The sniper was doing a lot of work then, and he's not doing as much now. So here comes our Wrangled Mini. It's going to go down pretty soon, but did some good damage, and everyone's at half right now. So let's see where people spawn from. I'm going to watch in the back just to see where the outlines come in. Yeah, so they do spawn back at spawn after the first point there. Looks like the spawns for the second round aren't changed for anybody. Second round. Oh, I mean second cap. We posted right in the middle. Kind of in shooting spot, but he has to get off of it because Doman's really good at pushing heavies out of position. Great job getting around the whole cliff side. He's going to have to be cloaked soon, though. Medic's right here. You're going to have a play. NG as well. NG might. Oh, there's the pyro. Gets him at just the right time. That sucks. Surprise pyros are like the worst thing to happen to you as a spy. They're very frustrating to play against. So we just got Uber. We had a desperation pop because there's a pyro behind. So that's unfortunate. So not a ton of is gonna come of it, but you know they did get the point. What that probably means is that Red's gonna have to probably despawn all the way back, and let's see where the spy spawns real quick. Yeah, he spawns way back. Yeah, he spawns all the way back at the second spawn. So now spawns have been reset. Now even though you have to push through tunnel, your spawn distances are majorly imbalanced. See if this pyro wraparound comes up anything. You probably can't get the scout. This is just too open for a scout to get. What is this fight? No, he's not sapping anything. Those are flowers. Interesting dual battle over here. Tell you what, let's watch someone on the red team. Let's watch the sniper. Well, he won't get out here. Holding up in this barn behind concrete is probably a good thing to do. Just so the distance is so short to where the cart is right now that blue team certainly wants to take it. Oh, you got that bail. You got that bail position right there as well. He's got a trap in place. Didn't detonate it right. That's okay. Sniper took out the medic. I have no idea where he was posted, but that'll be good for stopping this push. Now, does blue spawn from the same location now? So the spawn wave just came up. No, they get a forward spawn. Yeah, so spawns are majorly imbalanced for blue. Because red has to go through 2 points, and blue only has to go through one to get up to the cart. Great use of the disciplinary action there to keep your teammates out and going, especially in like a situation like this where distances are huge. Oh, he got knocked off. That's really bad. He needs to get upstairs right now. Pyro's doing a good job of keeping them active. He's being really paranoid for spies. He barely missed him, which is unfortunate, but I don't think the spy's gonna be able to do much here. These rafters are tiny enough that spies don't have any leeway in maneuvering to get the perfect stat that they need. Spies generally need more open areas than they give them credit for. Like everyone says you need like cover, and you do, for like escaping and things. Oh, Uber come in. Great control by the pyro to keep this Uber like locked down. That was probably his greatest contribution to the team this round. Completely neutralized that Uber, and yeah, they lost a They lost a sentry gun, but that sentry gun can come back up, and they totally cleaned up out off of it. Koga didn't get his Ubersol there, hit there. He would be at more than 25 right now if he did. So great job of the pyro there. Poking with the head. Ooh, stand up on the boxes, get some cover. This is a really good tactic that a lot of heavies and lower levels don't do. Your hitbox is really hard to get to, but generally your viewport isn't going to change that much. I'm going to try a back cap from the scout here. If he can get it, that would be really good for them. And he does. So does that give them a new spawn? Let's find out. So looking for the soldier. Soldier just got up. Soldier just spawned from here. Jesus. So now that they got this, they... Spawn distances are long enough that they just have to spawn. They just have to, like, trade evenly. This sentry gun I don't like at all. The sentry gun's way too open. They can come over to the side here and easily kill it. Now, that teleporter I really like. This teleporter is against a dead-end area, meaning that it's not going to get wrapped around on. You're not going to worry about people getting stabbed, generally. I mean, a spy could theoretically go over there and like, a chain stab on you. Get a teleport stab on you. But, it's way out of the way. It's hard to get to. Now, this is a sentry gun position I like. It's up on the top here. If you try and jump it and you don't do your jump angle correctly, you're not going to be able to see it. This cover is going to be in the way. They come from the right direction though. Going to get some sticks out there. Shoot it. Oh, you missed your shot. Oh, but you got it again. And look, Rescue Ranger saved that sentry gun, and it did 1 point of damage to the scout, and it had to be taken out by the sniper instead. Nope, spies all over the medic here. He goes to the teleporter instead of like trying to pistol the medic though. I'm not sure that's the right choice. Well, I mean they do clean him up afterwards. 5:30 in three points. That seems like, I'm gonna guess that's like an average time for this map. I obviously don't know. I've never played this map before. But if I had to guess, it seems like it's been a pretty close game so far. People have won and lost round battles, and it hasn't been like. Like, the first round was just SS won every battle. SS took every medic advantage and did a really good job cleaning up and really took position very quickly. That's really the thing you have to do. Like, you want to take position really quickly in this game, right? But you got to get in the right cards to do it. What is that? Is he running the Force of Nature now? We have to get back on this cam. Watch this Force of Nature play. That's crazy shit, man. Everyone else, besides this Rescue Ranger, is pretty standard. Alright, where are you, Tipsy? Oh, he went back! That's lame. Now he's using the Fire Stick for some strange reason. It's widely regarded as the worst melee for Scout to have in the game. I don't know why he just doesn't have an Atomizer instead. It's really strange. Oh, the whole team wants to go through here. Soldier gets caught, but he moves out through the flank side. Good. The Demoman basically bought themselves 2 seconds from the entire team. And wow, medic gets picked by the sniper. They really wanted that push there, and that's gonna cost them. That's gonna cost them dearly. That medic pick was just huge. So not only did it kill the medic, it ended up on follow-up kills when they wanted to be aggressive. Because when you get in an aggressive position, you say, hey, we want to go and kill all of them, but we're going to really risk getting position to do it. They took all the risk and got none of the reward. Doxed. Doxed? I used to know a guy named Dox. I wonder if he's the same guy. He has a ring. That's cute. Nice shot. I think someone called him out to him there. Someone called the sniper, because he didn't like look at him before he shot him. Yeah, so this seems like a pretty good sniper position for sure. I wouldn't really want you like sniping from the right side, because it really seems like that's where they want to push from. Maybe the blue team has too much of a bias to pushing on defenders right, attackers left. Maybe they should push from left a little bit more. Even though it's a lower angle, you gotta like make them mix it up, and you gotta like force them to spread a little bit better. Oh, Uber happened, huh? Medic's running Bloodsauger. I'm not a fan. I'm not a fan of the Bloodsauger because you lose passive regen, and what you want to be doing is you want to be healing as much as possible. When you're not healing, you're implicitly losing. Oh crap, I've got the bug where I'm zoomed in a little bit farther than I want to be because I looked at a sniper who was scoped. So now we're fine. Scout gets sniped. Yeah, they can't seem to make this happen. Like, this fortress, this red fortress is just seeming to be impenetrable right now. And look, they're pushing from attackers left, defenders right again. Now they're like posted up. They have Uber advantage, so they can't drop again. We gotta make sure the sniper doesn't get him. If the sniper doesn't get him this time, Spy's not in a position to go take him right now. The sentry gun's in a very killable position. If you can wrap around the whole left side, which, you know, doesn't seem that far, but you have to walk up these stairs, you have to go around this corner, you have to take the long way to get there. And the combo's not even posted up there, so if you get the sentry, like, they're very well spread here.
Yeah, I'm still fine though, so.
This defense is, I wouldn't say perfect, but very optimal for what they need to do right now. Spy in the back, I don't know why he's running for the pyro. No, he's just running back. Do they have a teleporter? I think he thinks they have a teleporter. Let's find out. We're gonna miss all the action just to check the teleporter. Oh, hey, they do have a teleporter. It's gone now. Where was it? Anyway. Scout goes below. You're gonna... Scout's behind, so this could be big. If you can make a ninja pick right here to make sure the sentry gun doesn't stay up. Oh, but I mean, I already missed all the action, so. Yeah, so SS, they gotta practice. They gotta practice this last push, for sure. You need to play against more teams and practice getting into this last tier, because everything else went relatively smoothly for them. The first 3 points were not so bad at all. This last one has been a nightmare. There are only 4 ways into the point from here. I say only 4, it's kind of a lot. But those 4 ways quickly become 1, 2, well, there's still 4, but they actually change. You have 2 entrances from this side, and 2 exits from this side. So that's kind of interesting. Whoa, you can be up here? That's cool. Go help your demo. What are you doing? That scout should have died. Red scout should be dead by right now. So now they're getting desperate, I'm sure of it. Like, now they're pushing one at one, and then the heavy's making a lot of kills. Heavy is the guy who does well when the enemy team is flustered, when the enemy team is desperate, and doesn't know how to push. Ooh, nice, crits comes in. And get the oh, he does. Great pipe on the medic. Great last-ditch pipe. Medic could have been more served by just chilling out here for a second, then he could have left, I think. But, you know, hindsight. So that switch to crits was surprising. I didn't see it coming. I wasn't expecting it. They have about a 40% advantage now, because they're not... Well, yeah, 40% advantage. Are they still running Uber? No, they're running crits, I think. Find out. I'm pretty sure it's crits. Yeah, it's a crits creek. So both teams are running crits now. The guy doesn't want to stay behind an Uber during crits for so long, but guess what? Like, even a 10% crits advantage is massive compared to like a 10% Uber advantage, where you can delay an Uber even if you're not being Ubered long enough for you to do a counter Uber. But with crits, it's like, well, I was 5% there and then I die because crits are instant and unforgiving. Let's see if Demo Man pushes through again. Yep, here he comes. Oh no, I thought I heard him go. Now he goes, but they pushed the wrong side that time. They got stuffed. Flanks try and come in. Scout's actually getting behind. The sniper is not where he wants to be at all. The sniper's not having a good game. So, not a great crit, but not the end of the world either. Apparently the blue medic critted as well. I don't think they got anyone like super important though. They got the spy, the pyro, the soldier. Ah, the spy had to like reset or something, because there's definitely no way he has 0 points. Sucks. I wish I knew how well the spy did this game. So we're pushing through attackers left again. It does give you the most options for getting in there, because you've got two entrances here. But then the sentry gun is at a really good angle to go kill it. A really good angle. Like, okay, this cover you can shoot to like hurt it. But Wrangle is stopping that mainly, and because you can Wrangle from a safe zone. Another crits comes in, cleans them all out. Are they going to be able to get this fourth point? Signs are pointing to no. This defense was like impeccable. This soldier, I think, is a big part of it too. Like, the soldier has been so mobile, like getting on flanked areas, using his rocket jumps to get to places where he needs to be. Making sure that every like doorway is covered is sort of like really important when you hold the fortress at the end of a payload map. So that sucks for SS. They couldn't get the last point in, and they have to start playing desperately now at the third point. So they have two ways to win now. They could either fully capture in the normal allotted amount of time, or they could capture 3 points in less than 5.5 minutes. That last part seems difficult, but if they even get close to it, then SS has to throw their entire lineup. They have to throw their entire team behind it. They can't worry about the future. They have to like stop the push, because if they push in, they win. It's not like a win off of 3 points versus a win off of 4 points is any different. So they just have to like force a really bad fight and try and desperately hold on to the round if it gets really close at the three point mark. But even if they don't get it, when you generally have to commit like that, you're generally going to lose it anyway, and then they're going to be able to get a good push into fourth right after that. Now, push into fourth is kind of long. If you want to have to worry about a bad situation like that, I'd much rather have that red fortress than right up here in the first point. Great pipe to begin with. I guess there's a health back in there that I never noticed. So this is interesting. We got a split defense here. We have the core on the left, attackers left, sentry gun on the right, and flanks are on the right as well. Sniper's moving up. Oh man, Spy should have gone for that kill there. Probably. I mean, sniper seems to be a big problem here. And so the snipers seem to be trading very well, but I think the blue sniper has been doing a little bit better. If we look at the scores, yeah, blue sniper has made a few more points. Probably has a few more kills to his name. So that's probably helped them out. Soldier went in, got a bomb. I killed the medic. So this cast is a little scattered because I don't know the map very well. And I'm just kind of fascinated by like what everyone's doing. So they're at half people. So they had to back off. Ooh, what's this spy gonna do back there? He's just gonna die. Okay. So now they have to go the entire distance to get out here. That buys the blue team time to get the first point. 1 minute for the first point. That seems to be about what the time has been for the most part so far. These first point caps have been very fast, and they're generally supposed to be. These short circuits are great. This engineer is really contributing a lot to stopping the spam on his team. Uber the Pyro as a backup, don't like that so much. But it looks like this is a good concrete defense here. We got a level 3 below. Getting zapped. Oh man, that was such an unlucky hit. That Pyro was just too low. Oh no, wasn't able to save the gun in time, so like now it's going to be a good push in. If that gun had stayed up, this push would have been delayed and maybe a play could have happened, but NG goes down. What are you doing, medic? This is not where you want to be. That was a huge mistake. Huge mistake by the medic there. Now they have 3 minutes to push through this big barn area. The T-bones. We'll call it the T-bones because there are no T-shapes in here, so T-bones it is. So getting into T-bones is going to be like easy peasy breezy, because they're not even set up for it. Sentry gun's not even gone yet. It's been harassed out. No sentry gun in T-bones. It's not good. They had an Uber off, so... Oh, and Red's running Crit Screak? I think you have to run. This is sort of a desperation Crit Screak. You need Crit Screak before they can Uber, but you didn't get it this time. body cleaned up. And that fight actually went very well, but they lost territory for it. So it's a minor victory on their part. Because they still lost territory. Payload is like feet away from winning the game for them. And they have 2 minutes to do it, which is a pretty long time for this map, as we've seen. Ah, soldiers coming up around here. Great. That's cool. I like that angle. You get seen, you can also see them. So their flanks are dead. That means now is probably a good time to go. And the spy's dead. Now is probably a good time to go. Oh wait, they don't have overcharge at all. They know the crits is coming too, so. Okay, so now what you need to do is you need to spread. That's exactly what we're doing. We're seeing their own flanks like move forward. Doman is probably a little bit posted too far forward. He gets back out though, medic was right there, so that was good. So they're 20% away now, the crits hasn't been popped yet. Red hasn't been aggressive enough to go for it. I think they're just scared. I think they really don't want to like lose this at the 3-point mark. So NG goes down. That means healing this entry is impossible now. Ah, there's the crits. Great crits. Nice triple kill. Finally gets it off. And looks like Blue is running crits too. I felt like if it was an Uber, it would have been much better. This area is tiny. That crits are gonna destroy you in it. So if your enemy team is running crits, I mean you have a big buffer zone here. Like, okay, they come from one of these entrances. Where are you gonna be? You can be posted over here, posted down here, you can be posted up here. They have to find you. You can be in all of these places with all of your team members. And if you're back out here, it's hard to make a good crit happen. But if you're inside here, as we saw, crits can do really good. So I would recommend what they're doing right now. Using an Uber because they know the crits are there and they're not pressuring what they don't think they can get. Like nothing's been like a desperation play yet. So. NG went down to spam. He probably shouldn't have gone for the stuff as much as he did. Sentry's down, move that mini up. Let's get some cover over here. Demoman has to make this last ditch effort. Here we go. He's gotta go in. That's game for sure. Oh, Snipes comes in for the last minute. NG comes in for the last minute. Will this be it? Medic comes in for the last minute. Nah, he dies. Too bad. So good job to whatever team won here. The guy who sent me this replay wasn't in this cast at all, or wasn't named what he was named. So now I'm gonna have to like correlate what his aliases are to like what the people of this game are. So that's gonna be a bitch. Oh, well, already kicked out to the game menu. So that was a Turbo Cup cast of Borneo. I had a really good time doing that, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.